or out of ideas, but the violent currents that brought him here have scattered the pages he has written.
Oi. Eu tô.
The lights of the motel promise safety. The man senses that the solution to his predicament begins there.
É.
Somewhere within the earth, space itself has been pierced, and from dark depths runs a steady flow of monsters. The man recognizes the hand of his evil double in this. He knows he must put an end to this madness.
Stay here now.
Pariu, velho.
Just to be clear, you should know that we haven't actually met before.
Sure we have, Mr. Wake. Remember, you stayed at the motel here.
No, the guy you're talking about just looks like me, even if he uses my name. He's behind all this trouble.
Oh, I thought, Now that you mention it, I guess your aura looks a lot nicer than his, actually. I'm very sensitive to things like that.
The Champion of Light recognizes the page he got from the woman. It is a weapon of his own design, custom engineered to destroy the dark portal. If he recreates the conditions of the page, a great power will be unleashed.
Wait! That's one thing down. Just one more to go.
Tears itself in two to avoid the hated light. It becomes weaker, but more numerous. Such is the arithmetic of horror.
That was just messed up. That's everything.
The man has found the battery, but it is empty. It will need to be recharged.
Hell, this isn't gonna be good.
Is this on?
I need this battery charged.
No.
Listen, I don't know what's gonna happen exactly when I do this. My memory's a little hazy.
Thank you.
This isn't gonna be good. Time to make some serious changes.
The color grids down all invaders. about to enjoy another cool Arizona night with me, Eddie Rodman, the host with the most. Hey, any of you guys remember...
What the hell was...
Are you okay?
I guess. Thanks for the help. Were those the... what do you call them? The Taken? What are they?
It's complicated. Short version, the darkness can take people over. That's why I had to destroy the oil derrick. Otherwise, they would have overrun the place.
Wow, I didn't think you'd actually do it. I mean, I didn't think it'd work. That's crazy.
Let me just try one more time at the risk of sounding like a broken record. It's bad out there. I don't want you hurt. You should stay put.
Yeah, while you turn this place into an inferno, run around shooting things up and play some kind of weird games with your psycho evil twin. Don't get me wrong, you're nice for a weirdo. I'm impressed as hell by all of this, but enough is enough. I seriously just want to get out of here, okay?
Washington, and it was obvious to me that they still got it. So I figured, hey, let's make some music, right? And they went for it.
Now, Barry, you were a literary agent before this, right?
Uh-huh.
And you were very... You represented Alan Wake. Why don't we take a little break, and then later on in the program, we'll hear the new Old God single. Stay tuned.
Poltergeist. Its existence is one of rage and hostility, and its very presence turns ordinary objects into deadly projectiles.
Oh, shit!
The scene, traces of violence, a callous midnight snack, a room key left carelessly behind. The man recognizes the enemy's handiwork.
I think these are keys for the motel rooms. Satellite and now this? That place might be involved.
Thomas Sloan was a believer in a great many things, most of which were entirely fallacious. Emma Sloan, an innocent victim of his dark half. More collateral damage in the ongoing war. Damned by forces beyond her control, as much as by her own actions.
I guess it's about time I went full auto. Damn it! Why didn't you listen?
Michael Farabee, dead, tortured, dressed in clothes that bore the name of a local observatory. A slim lead, but solid enough. It stirs something deep in his mind. He knows where to go now. The observatory, hot on the heels of the Herald of Darkness, the champion of light forges on to see the stars. An observatory, a place for a man to witness the magnificence of the universe. But such insights are not what the Champion of Light is looking for. He has come to find a weapon.
Welcome back, listeners. As you know, I'm Eddie Rodman, and I'm still talking to old gods of Asgard, who are doing their big comeback tour. How's that been going for you? Odin?
Splendid! I'm having the time of my life! You know, I didn't realize how much I'd miss that.
And what about you, Thor?
It's okay, you know.
Well, this must bring back a lot.
Hello? I'm Dr. Rachel Meadows, and... Wait a moment, it's you! I can't believe you dare show your face around here again.
It wasn't me. I just look like him.
Are you serious? That's what you're going with? Please!
I'm trying to stop him. You saw those shadow things trying to kill me, right? I bet he got along with them just fine.
Yes. Yes, he did. All right. Come on in.
Thank you.
buddy. I figured I'd take a moment to talk to you. There's a party next door. Between us. It's a little weird for me too, you know?
Just a moment, I'll send the lift down to you.
I know you're right.
I didn't expect to see anyone here tonight, but I'm relieved to see an actual person. That's assuming this isn't some kind of cruel trick on your part, of course.
Tell me more about the signal.
It's almost as if something's being transmitted to Night Springs. It's the strangest thing. It's quite elusive, almost as if it wasn't properly there. I don't know how to describe it.
So, what was the signal like?
I wish I knew. He appeared before I had a good fix on it. He was very pleasant when I was working, but when I isolated the signal, he suddenly... But suddenly he became...
Good luck. And try to be careful. It's a very expensive part and we don't have a replacement. Oh dear, that sounded more callous than I intended. Be safe.
This must be your car.
Thank you. I found it!
Excellent. I'll operate the platform directly below the telescope so you can install the array. Don't worry, it's very easy. Brilliant, you've got it. I'll just run a quick diagnostic on it. Yes, it's in perfect order. All right, we're good to go. Let's take a look at the skies. Automated coolant system. Somebody just interrupted the flow.
So now what?
Well, you could go and open the secondary coolant flow valves manually. I know it's dangerous there, but, well...
I got it!
Please come talk to me if you have questions.
There's something I should know about this coolant thing?
Oh no, it's quite straightforward. The telescope is very heavy, and moving it generates a lot of heat. So do all of the electronics. Overheating could cause damage, so it shuts down automatically if the coolant fluid isn't flowing. And hot electronics generate instrument noise, which we want to eliminate as much as possible.
What is this? Anyway, is it dangerous?
We use liquid nitrogen. It's quite safe.
If I can make it to the valves in one piece.
Yes, there is that. Good luck.